Last week, I published a video telling you about my experiences as an environmental educator. If you haven't seen that video, you can click up here. In it, I talked a lot about what environmental ed means to me. But what is environmental education? When I told you what environmental education means to me, I used lots of stories to explain my point of view, but it's difficult to pack all of those feelings and experiences into a single definition. So what is environmental education, officially? There are lots of different definitions depending on who you talk to. The North American Association for Environmental Education says that environmental ed is a process that helps individuals, communities, and organizations learn more about the environment and develop skills and understanding about how to address global challenges. That's pretty basic, right? The NAAEE definition covers learning about the environment, and also goes a little farther by talking about addressing challenges. The United States Environmental Protection Agency takes the definition a step further, calling environmental ed a process that allows individuals to explore environmental issues, engage in problem solving, and take action to improve the environment. As a result, individuals develop a deeper understanding of environmental issues and have the skills to make informed and responsible decisions. This time, we get a sense that environmental ed is about more than just facts. It's about activism. I like this definition because, to me, environmental education isn't complete until a learner feels a connection, a sense of responsibility to nature, and a desire to act in the environment's best interests. The Colorado Alliance for Environmental Education says it's a lifelong learning process that increases awareness about the environment and its systems while developing critical thinking skills that enable responsible decision-making. The phrase lifelong learning process is also very important to me. You're never too old to be learning about your environment. Many environmental educators focus on children because kids are the future, but the environment needs our help right now, so it's important to include adults in our educational process. If we take all of my favorite parts from these definitions and squash them together, we might get a definition that we can sink our teeth into. Environmental education is a lifelong learning process that helps individuals, communities, and organizations learn more about the environment, explore environmental issues to gain a deeper understanding of the relationship between humans and the environment, and develop critical thinking skills that enable responsible decision-making and environmental activism. Yeah, that feels pretty good to me. What do you think? Is there anything you would add to my definition? So, I obviously think that environmental education is important, but why is that? Lady Bird Johnson, when she was First Lady of the United States, wrote, "The environment, after all, is where we all meet, where we all have a mutual interest. It is one thing that all of us share. It is not only a mirror of ourselves, but a focusing lens on what we can become." That sense of connection is exactly what environmental education seeks to foster in people. I don't know if you've noticed, but you live in the environment, and so do I. All humans, regardless of how far they live from perceived nature, still rely on it. If the environment is destroyed, we won't survive long without it. But can environmental education achieve the goals we've set for it? When done correctly, it certainly can. A study in London followed a group of almost 200 elementary school students on a series of environmental education field trips. Attending a live animal show allowed the children to make comparisons between themselves and the animals, opening up their minds to compassion for the animals and other parts of nature. Exploring at a nearby nature center allowed the kids to develop their questioning skills, as well as an awareness for the local environment. A visit to a natural history museum exercised the kids' observational skills and got them thinking about environmental careers. During all three outings, the children were exposed to previously unknown things, fostering their discovery and engagement with the natural world. As the researchers put it, one key idea in biology conservation education is that the living world is of personal worth to the learner. And I would completely agree. If you know about something, you can seek to understand it. If you understand something, you can seek to care about it. And if you care about something, you can seek to protect it. Emotional connections are how we foster the next generation of environmental activists and stewards. Do you think environmental education is important? In the comments, let me know about any awesome environmental ed experiences you've had as a learner or as a teacher. As always, I'll be happy to answer any questions. Links and citations to all of the research sources I used will be down in the description. If you liked this video, don't forget to like it. If you didn't like it, please share it with someone who would. And if you'd like to support the Roving Naturalist, please remember to subscribe and follow us on Facebook and Twitter. I'll see you next time.